Good evening students, hope you have followed the first video and recalled all the lessons for the coming SSC public examinations. Firstly, I would like to tell you one important point. Dear students, always work hard for progress, not for perfection, because nobody can become perfect or nobody can achieve anything in one day or 2 days. పని ఏదైనా సరే చివరి రోజు వరకు చేస్తూనే ఉండండి, అది మీ SSC ఎగ్జామ్స్ అయ్యేంత వరకు చేస్తూనే ఉండండి. రైట్, రిమెంబర్ ద ప్రాబ్ వాట్ రోమ్ వాజ్ నాట్ బిల్ట్ ఇన్ ఎ డే. రైట్, ఓకే, అండ్ డోంట్ ఫర్గెట్ దట్ నథింగ్ ఈజ్ ఇంపాసిబుల్ టు ఎ విల్లింగ్ హార్ట్. అట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్ ప్లాన్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఫర్ యువర్ ఎగ్జామ్స్. ఆఫ్టర్ ప్లానింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ఇట్. సో ప్లాన్, ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ఇట్ అండ్ అచీవ్ ఇట్. యూ నీడ్ టు ఎంజాయ్ యువర్ ప్రిపరేషన్ టైమ్. Make your time best use of it. అంటే కష్టపడడం కాదు, ఇష్టపడడం ప్లస్ కష్టపడడం. సో ఇది మా ఎస్ఎస్సి ప్రిపరేషన్కి చాలా అవసరం. రైట్, గవర్నమెంట్ పేపర్, వీ హ్యావ్ గాట్ టూ ఇంగ్లీష్ పేపర్స్ ఫర్ అవర్ ఎస్ఎస్సి ఎగ్జామ్స్, దట్ ఈస్ పేపర్ వన్ అండ్ పేపర్ టూ, ఈచ్ క్యారీ 40 మార్క్స్. నౌ వీ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ ఇంగ్లీష్ పేపర్ వన్, విచ్ కంప్లీట్లీ డీల్స్ విత్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్. That is, the questions comes from textbook having 3 sections. It has got section A, reading comprehension, section B with vocabulary and grammar, and section 3, creative writing, nothing but discourses. Today we will be focusing on section A, reading comprehension, as well as section B, vocabulary and grammar. When it comes to the point of section A, that is, we will be having 2 passages. In the very first passage, there will be 7 questions. Out of 7 questions, you will be having 4 multiple choice questions and 3 questions where you need to answer them, answer for 3 to 4 lines. In the second paragraph as well, it will be the same. But here, the awarding of marks to the questions in case of paragraph 1 will be 2 marks, whereas in the second paragraph, it will be 1 mark to the each question, right? And next, whenever you are attempting these multiple choice questions, make sure that you have to use the capital letter. That is, you need to write the capital letter. From both the paragraphs, there will be a kind of question. There is at least one question that has to be answered in your point of view. Now we will be discussing about the comprehension. What exactly is comprehension? Comprehension is nothing but ardham chesukodam ante. Like, understand something, what is given in the textbook. Right, that's nothing but called as comprehension. And whenever you want to do the comprehension, it depends upon the children mindset as well. Children who are intelligent, right, especially they prefer to read the paragraphs first, they prefer to read the questions first, then they try to answer the question answers by seeing the paragraphs. Ante evaraithe above average లేకపోతే హై అచీవర్స్ మనం అనుకుంటామో వాళ్ళు ఏం చేస్తారంటే ఫస్ట్ పారాగ్రాఫ్స్ చదవరు, క్వశ్చన్స్ చదివేస్తారు. క్వశ్చన్స్ చదివేసి ఆ తర్వాత పారాగ్రాఫ్స్ చదువుతారు అనమాట. ఇది యూనివర్సల్లీ యాక్సెప్టెడ్ ఆర్ యూనివర్సల్ అప్రూవ్డ్ ఫార్ములా. అంటే హియర్ ద చైల్డ్ విల్ హ్యావ్ ఎ క్యూరియాసిటీ టు సర్చ్ ద ఆన్సర్ ఆఫ్టర్ రీడింగ్ ద క్వశ్చన్, అండ్ ఈవెన్ ఇట్ విల్ బి వెరీ యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ హిమ్ టు ఆన్సర్ ఇట్ వెరీ ఈజీలీ. అండ్ అంటే ఇక్కడ సింపుల్గా చెప్పాలంటే తను పారా టు క్వశ్చన్ కాకుండా క్వశ్చన్ టు పారాగ్రాఫ్ వెళ్తాడనమాట. రైట్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఏ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ కాన్సెప్ట్, ఇంపార్టెంట్ మైండ్ సెట్ అనొచ్చు. లైక్ వాట్ ద హై అచీవర్స్ యూజువల్లీ ఫాలో దిస్ ప్యాటర్న్. వెన్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ టు ద సెకండ్ ప్యాటర్న్, అంటే సెకండ్ ప్యాటర్న్లో బిలో యావరేజ్ కావచ్చు, లో అచీవర్స్ కావచ్చు, వాళ్ళు ఎలా ప్రిఫర్ చేయాలి అంటే దే హ్యావ్ టు రీడ్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్ ట్వైస్ ఆర్ అట్లీస్ట్ థ్రైస్. Twice at least or thrice, because when they read, that will help them to get the information from the passage, right? And besides that, why I'm asking them to read twice or thrice in a sense, because they will come to know from which lesson or whether the paragraph is having a కాంటాక్ట్ విత్ ద ప్రీవియస్ పారాగ్రాఫ్ అండ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ పారాగ్రాఫ్. అంటే మనకి ఏదైతే పారాగ్రాఫ్ ఇచ్చింటారో ఆ పారాగ్రాఫ్కి ముందర ఉన్న పారాగ్రాఫ్తో లింక్ అయి ఉంటుంది కంపల్సరీగా. అలాంటి పారాగ్రాఫ్స్ మనకి ఎగ్జామ్స్లో వస్తాయి. రైట్, నౌ వీ హ్యావ్ టేకెన్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫ్రమ్ ద లెసన్ బ్రేవ్ పాటర్. ఇప్పుడు బ్రేవ్ పాటర్లో ఒక ఎగ్జాంపుల్ తీసుకున్నా, అది ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తాను. బట్ బిఫోర్ దట్, ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు డూ సచ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ప్యాటర్న్, వాట్ ఆర్ ద స్టెప్స్ టు బి ఫాలోడ్ బై ఏ లో అచీవర్ ఆర్ యావరేజ్ స్టూడెంట్? రైట్, హియర్ దెర్ ఆర్ 3 మేజర్ స్టెప్స్. ద వెరీ ఫస్ట్ స్టెప్ ఇస్ స్కిమ్. Skim refers to here the child has to get a clear idea from which lesson we got this passage and what is the theme of the given paragraph. And a lesson nunchi e comprehension passage anedi vachindi. ఈ పారాగ్రాఫ్ యొక్క మెయిన్ థీమ్ ఏంటి అనే దాన్ని మనం స్కిమ్మింగ్ అంటాం. ఈ స్కిమ్మింగ్ని కంపల్సరీగా ఫాలో అయిపోవాలి. ఎందుకంటే ఇది ఈ స్కిమ్మింగ్ రావాలంటే అట్లీస్ట్ మనం ట్వైస్ ఆర్ థ్రైస్ చదివితే తప్ప మనకి రాదనమాట. రైట్, సెకండ్ పాయింట్ దట్ ఈస్ స్కానింగ్. స్కానింగ్ హియర్ యూ నీడ్ టు స్కాన్ ఫర్ ద స్పెసిఫిక్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ డీటెయిల్స్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ద క్యారెక్టర్స్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ ద పారాగ్రాఫ్ దట్ ఈస్ కాంప్రిహెన్షన్. అండ్ లాస్ట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్లైన్ ద వొకాబులరీ, అంటే ఇంపార్టెంట్ టర్మినాలజీ వర్డ్స్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో అండర్లైన్ చేస్తే మనకు ఆన్సర్స్ రాసేటప్పుడు ఇవన్నీ ఈజీ అవుతాయి అనమాట. రైట్, నెక్స్ట్ ద లాస్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ అనాలిసిస్. అనాలిసిస్ హియర్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అనలైజ్ ద ఎగ్జాక్ట్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ బికాస్ వెన్ ఎవర్ యూ హ్యావ్ ద ఎబిలిటీ టు అనలైజ్ ద ఎగ్జాక్ట్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ యూ కెన్ క్లియర్లీ ఎలిమినేట్ ద ఫాల్స్ సెక్షన్. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ this analysis section will help you. So the very first one is skimming, the second one is scanning, and the third one is analysis. Skimming means to get the overall theme from the passage, from which lesson he has given the passage. Scanning, you have to underline the important terminology. Ayi bold lo icchara italic lo icchara koncham observe chesi manaku kanapadipothayi, vaatni chusukoni underline chesukovali anamata. Ante aa word question lo unda ledha, question lo unda answer lo unda ledha check chesukodaniki upayogapadutundi. Next one, last one is analysis. Analysis makes you to be perfect with your answers, especially the multiple choice question answers, children. Right? Next, now we'll be moving into the paragraph with the example. Right. Now I'll be reading the paragraph. Based on that, the questions are posed on the blackboard. First, we'll read the paragraph. Then, how to answer to such kind of questions will be discussed now. On the afternoon of that day, a potter had arrived home after a hard day's work. He was tired and thirsty. He had asked his wife for some palm wine. Right here, on the afternoon of that day, what happened? The potter had arrived home after a hard day's work. That is, after reading the very first line, we need to know whether this paragraph is from which lesson. Right? And besides, what was the character involved in the very first line? He has given as a potter. And what was his condition? So you need to analyze these kind of things in the paragraph. Next, he was tired and thirsty. He was tired and thirsty means baga alisipoyadu anamata. Dantho paatu tappuga kuda unnadu. He asked his wife for some palm wine. So what did he ask? He asked some palm wine. Palm wine you need to underline. Right? The more he drank, the better he felt. ఎంత ఎక్కువ తాగాడో అంత బెటర్గా ఫీల్ అయ్యాడు అనమాట. వెన్ హీ డ్రంక్ ఆల్ ద వైన్ హీ నో లాంగర్ ఫెల్ టైర్డ్. వెన్ ద స్ట్రామ్ బిగాన్ ద పాటర్ సడన్లీ రిమెంబర్డ్ దట్ హీ హ్యాడ్ లెఫ్ట్ హిస్ డాంకీ టైర్డ్ అండర్ ఎ ట్రీ. రైట్, ఆఫ్టర్ హ్యావింగ్ ద పామ్ వైన్ హీ హ్యాస్ రియలైజ్డ్ దట్ హిస్ డాంకీ వాస్ టైర్డ్ అవుట్సైడ్ ద హౌస్ దట్ టు వెన్ ద స్ట్రామ్ హ్యాస్ బిగాన్. As soon as the storm has begun, he remembered that he has to get back his donkey into the house. That is, to the hut. He rushed out of his hut to take the animal into the stable. Now, he decided to get back the donkey into the stable. What does the stable mean? A stable is a place where animals are kept. So, you need to underline this word as well. You can imagine his anger when he discovered that the donkey was not there anymore. The only thing left was its chain. So as soon as he went outside the house, right, he haven't found his donkey, and he was completely in a position like he was completely angered towards his donkey where it was gone. And what could he find over there? He could find only a chain. My stupid donkey must have run off into the forest, he grumbled. When I catch him, I'll give him a good beating. So now he is saying that as soon as I catch my donkey, I'll give him a left and right. That is, he want to kick it because it left towards the forest. Right. Now I'll be explaining you the questions related to the paragraph. The very first question, when I catch him, I'll give him a good beating. That is, unless or until the child has got a good understanding over the lesson, he cannot answer such kind of questions. So it's very important for us to read the lesson because some of the questions will be related to the previous as well as to the continuation of the lesson. But here this question clearly indicates that the child should have an understanding over the lesson. Here when I catch him, so who is that? Him refers to the donkey. I refer to the potter. I'll give him a good beating. Good beating here refers to he wants to kick the donkey left and right. Next, did the potter really find his donkey? Did the potter really find this donkey? No, he haven't. He got the tiger instead of donkey. So the answer should be no. So your answering should be no, comma, then you need to give the explanation. You are not supposed to write yes or no. So make sure that whatever the answers you are going to write, give the explanation. That will make you to give the examiner might give you the full marks. Next, third question. When the potter noticed when his donkey was missing. See, this is very, very important. When did the potter, after having the combine, when it is about to start a heavy storm, right? ఒక తుఫాను మొదలవుతుంది అన్నంగా బయటికి వెళ్ళి చూస్తే అప్పుడు తన డాంకీ కనబడటం లేదు అనేది తెలుస్తుంది అన్నమాట. నెక్స్ట్ ఫోర్త్ వన్. మై స్టూపిడ్ డాంకీ మస్ట్ రన్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్ టు ద ఫారెస్ట్. హీ గ్రంబుల్డ్. హీ గ్రంబుల్డ్. వాట్ ఇస్ గ్రంబుల్డ్? హీ హియర్ హీ రెఫర్స్ టు ద పాటర్. ఇక్కడ మల్టిపుల్ చాయిస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఈ రకంగా అడుగుతాడు. ఏమని? Option A, what does he refers to? Here option A, he might be asking you leak. B, tiger. C, potter. D, some lady. So you should be very cautious. Arey mana lesson pair brave potter kada ikkada potter ni ichadu manam brave potter ayyade kada option none of the above ledu edo petta ayipothundi ani atlan kodandi because ippudu varaku potter was a normal potter. Once he caught the tiger, as well as once he won in the war against, when he fight against the enemies, then he will be considered a brave potter. So now the answer will be considered as B. Okay. And next, coming to the point of grumble. What does grumble refers to? It's nothing but a person. He is complaining about his donkey in a very serious manner. Next, coming to the fifth question. If you were a potter, would you give him a good beating? Why not? So here is a point of question. Imagine yourself as a potter and how you behave in that situation. And for example, I myself is imagining as a brave potter. I simply say that I love animals. I'll be searching for day one. If not, I'll go for the day two as well. I'm not in a position to kick my donkey harder. Right? Because I love my animals. That's what. Here as well, it's your point of view, what you would like to explain, what kind of answer you want to give over here. And last, right? Here, the grumble. The same word. What is the meaning of grumble? Grumble here refers to nothing but complaining in a serious manner. So this is the pattern in which the examiner is going to ask you the questions. And the same way you need to answer to all the questions. Now we are going to discuss section B, which carries 10 marks, which includes the grammar and vocabulary. Here we will be having three parts. That is, part A will be from 13 to 17. Each question will be carried 1 mark. We will be focusing especially on this part A. Here, literally to say, this one paragraph decides whether the child has the ability to score A1 or A2, right? And this editing might come from any lesson, right? And at the same time, if you know the rules, how to edit the passage and find out the errors, it will be easy for you to score full marks, that is 5 out of 5. Sometimes a sentence might have 2 errors as well. So we should be very cautious, especially when reading this paragraph, right? Now I am explaining the rules to be followed in order to identify the errors in the given passage. Okay, I'll be giving one rule along with its example. If you take the very first rule, that is tense based errors, right? That is nothing but tense based errors. Before that, you need to identify the paragraph
whether the paragraph is in past tense or present tense. మీకు ఇచ్చిన పారాగ్రాఫ్ ఫస్ట్ లైన్లో కానీ సెకండ్ లైన్లో కానీ మీరు బాగా చదివారంటే ఆ పారాగ్రాఫ్ పాస్ట్ టెన్స్లో ఉందా ప్రజెంట్ టెన్స్లో ఉందా అని మీకు తెలిసిపోతుంది. అక్కడికే మీకు ఒక 30 to 40% అనాలిసిస్ జరిగిపోతుంది, రైట్? సో ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ టెన్స్ బేస్డ్ ఎర్రర్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ రూల్ నెంబర్ వన్. ఇన్ టెన్స్ బేస్డ్ ఎర్రర్స్ యు నీడ్ టు నో వెదర్ ద సెంటెన్స్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద ప్రజెంట్ టెన్స్ ఆర్ పాస్ట్ టెన్స్, రైట్? ఇఫ్ ద సెంటెన్స్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ ఈస్, యామ్, ఆర్, హ్యాస్, హ్యావ్, దెన్ ద సెంటెన్స్ it will be in present tense. Or if the sentence has got was, were, had, would, could, you can simply come to a conclusion that the sentence is in past tense. So you have to identify the words, which words are there in the first line. For example, I have taken one example here. Example, there were so many famous personalities. If you take this sentence, there is no error అనేది లేదు, ద సెంటెన్స్ ఈస్ కంప్లీట్లీ రైట్. బట్ వీ నీడ్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై విత్ దిస్ వర్డ్ దట్ ద సెంటెన్స్ ఈస్ కంప్లీట్లీ ఇన్ ఏ పాస్ట్ టెన్స్, రైట్? అండ్ అట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై ఏ ఎర్రర్. అంటే ఇక్కడ వర్క్ ప్లేస్ లో వాజ్ అని కూడా ఇవ్వచ్చు అనమాట. దిస్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో ఏ మార్క్ ఫర్ అస్, దట్ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై దిస్ ఎర్రర్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రైట్ ద ఆన్సర్ వర్క్. I have taken one more example from my childhood. That is, his wife is horrified at the idea of a Muslim boy being invited to dine in her ritually pure kitchen. So here, his, that is our Subramanyam Iyer, right? Muslim boy refers to our Abdul Kalam. So his wife is horrified here. Is, so is will be coming under present tense, but our paragraph comes under past, so you have to add was. So in this way you have to identify the errors. Ante ippudu ee sentence edaithe teeskunamo ee sentence first sentence రూట్ అనమాట. మనం తీసుకునే ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ అన్నిటి కూడా రూట్. సో ఈ సెంటెన్స్ లో ఎర్రర్ అనేది లేదు. నేను ఒక ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్పాను అంతే. ఒకవేళ ఇదే దీన్ని కూడా రాంగ్ ఈ రకంగా ఇచ్చి మనం ఈ రకం కరెక్ట్ రాయాల్సిన పరిస్థితి కూడా ఏర్పడుతుంది, రైట్? హియర్ వెన్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ టు ద పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, హియర్ ద సెంటెన్స్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ గివెన్ ఇన్ ద టెన్స్ బేస్డ్ ఎర్రర్. హీ హాస్ గివెన్ యాజ్ ద ఆప్షన్ ఈజ్, బట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రైట్ ద ఆన్సర్ యాజ్ వాస్. దట్ విల్ బి ద ఆన్సర్. విల్ బి ఎంటరింగ్ ఇన్ టు ద రూల్ 2, దట్ ఈస్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి అగ్రీడ్ విత్ ద వర్బ్ ఆల్ ద టైమ్. When the subject is in singular, the verb should also be in singular. Or if the subject is in plural, the verb should also be in plural. This is also very important in finding out the errors. Here is one example. He is doing well. As the subject is singular, we are using singular form, right? Helping verb. And here as well, same. As we have got students, which is in plural, so we are taking as are. When it comes to the point of lesson example, right? Example number 2, that is rule number 2. Then, example 1, then the Second World War over and India's freedom was imminent. That is the Second World War, right? How many wars? Only one. So here you have to use was, right? Over and India's freedom was imminent. So you should be very careful in identifying the errors based upon the subject agree with the verb, right? Discussing the rule number 3, that is conjunction and. Whenever the conjunction and comes, you have to make sure that after using this and or before the and, the verb form, it should be of same kind. If it is in present tense, you have to use after as well as before, and you have to use the same form. The same will be applicable to the everything. Here for V2 form, V3 form, V4 as well as V5. Here V refers to nothing but verb. Here I have taken an example of past. I enjoyed and danced during the party. Here he has given very clearly the V2 form is followed by and is followed by again another V2 form. So this is the rule number 3. So make sure that whenever the conjunction AND comes, you have to make sure that the conjunction has got both the same verb forms, whether it is V1 followed by V1, V2 followed by V2, and so on, right? Now we will be discussing the rule number 4, that is, after the preposition 2, always you have to take the present verb form, right? That is, whenever we come across the word, that is preposition 2, we have to use only V1 form. For example, in general example, he is going to eat food or ate food. Usually this is wrong. You always need to write the present form of ate is eat. So he is going to eat food. Is it clear? Right. When it comes to the point of lesson example, she refused to serve Kalam in her kitchen. That is, here the lady, wife of Subramanyam Iyer, what she did? She refused to serve. So here the error will be identified and you have to write as serve, which is in the present form. So these are all the examples how you need to cope up with the errors. Now we will be discussing the rule number 5, right? That is while. Usually while is always followed by V4 form, that is ing form. For example, headmaster called me while I was teaching. Ante manaku while ane padam eppudu vachina sare aa sentence lo chivarku ing form tho close avutundi. That is what the rule number 5 suggests. So whenever we come across this word while in the sentence, always the ending of the sentence will be followed by ing form, right? That is rule number 5. And come back to the rule number 6. This date is always followed by the present verb form, that is V1. Whenever we come across the word did, always the verb should be in V1 form only. For example, she did not come to school. She did not come to school. ఇది కొంచెం జాగ్రత్తగా ప్లాన్ చేసుకొని, ఐ మీన్ లైక్ చూసుకొని మీరు రాయండి. ఓకేనా? దిస్ ఇస్ అబౌట్ ద రూల్ నెంబర్ 6. నెక్స్ట్ రూల్ నెంబర్ 7, దట్ ఈస్ సూపర్లేటివ్ డిగ్రీ. దట్ ఈస్ ద వర్డ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ కన్సిడర్డ్ టు బి ద సూపర్లేటివ్ డిగ్రీ, లైక్ బిగ్గెస్ట్, లార్జెస్ట్, కైండెస్ట్, స్మాలెస్ట్, dearest, right, highest, all these words comes under superlative degree, that is which has got est, right? The word which ends with est comes under superlative degree. Whenever we have superlative degree in a sentence, right, we have to use the article the. For example, our Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was one of a greatest personalities, right? Here I have told this as a superlative degree word. So here you have to identify the error as a and need to write the. So manaki itvanti words oka sentence lo vachinappudu mana em cheyali, aa వర్డ్ ఎస్పెషల్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ముందర కంపల్సరీగా ది అనే ఆర్టికల్ని యూజ్ చేయాలి. ఓకే, నౌ వీల్ బి డిస్కసింగ్ ద రూల్ నంబర్ 8, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫ్రేజల్ వర్బ్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ ఓపెన్ ద పేజ్ నంబర్ 111, దట్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టెక్స్ట్ బుక్, రైట్? ఇఫ్ యూ ఓపెన్ దిస్ పేజ్ నంబర్, ఫర్ ష్యూర్ యూ విల్ బి హ్యావింగ్ వన్ ఎర్రర్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ పేజ్. సో మేక్ షూర్ దట్ యూ కంప్లీట్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఫ్రేజల్ వర్బ్స్. దట్ ఈస్ here there are some prepositions where they are going to end immediately after the adjectives as well as verbs. For example, if you take I am amazed at you, surprised, amazed is always followed by at. Blind ga meer fix ayipovalante amazed tarvata em ostundi preposition ante at, right? Next, I am married to Radha, right? So here the examiner will be giving the error as with. So these are the common examples what we come across in the examination. When it comes to the point of example that is related to the textbook, he was very fond of Jimmy, right? He is very fond of Jimmy. Kani manaku exam lo error attani vachu, right? So you should be very careful with the phrasal verbs which has been mentioned in the page number 111. Okay, next, always depend is followed by on, applied for. So such kind of phrasal verbs has to be learned from your side, especially from the page number 111. So this will be completing the rule number 8. Discussing the rule number 9, that is articles. A and on are called as indefinite article and the is called as definite article. When it comes to A, right, they are nothing but A is used before consonants other than A, E, I, O, U, right? And is used before vowels which includes A, E, I, O, U. Here is an example. The whole country was filled with a unprecedented optimism, right? Here this consonant should not be there. That is, here this could be considered as an error. Here you can add an unprecedented optimism. So this is the error from this sentence. So you should be very cautious with the articles. I have given you the notes regarding articles. Just go through it once again. You will come to know the errors. That is how to identify the errors. Rule number 10, whenever we come across or whenever the sentence begin with one of, right, it has to be ended with plural noun. For example, one of, usually this will be considered as singular, that is the subject is in singular, but when it comes to the next, it has to be in plural form, that is the friends. One of my friends live in Hyderabad. Here the sentence has got the plural noun, but that is what I am saying. Usually whenever you come across this one of, mandatorily you have to use the plural noun. Here as well there is one more example, that is one of my relatives died yesterday. Only one among all the relatives, right? This is about the rule number 10, right? There are few more rules which are commonly asked in the public examinations, right, where they will be interchanging like the words like and, but, or, and, so that comes under conjunctions, right? And there are some other sentences where they will be replacing the answers with the help of adverbs in place of adjectives or adjectives in place of adverbs, right? For example, you can go through this conjunction, they come through you and not from you. So here the conjunction but is replaced as and. So this is the error. So you need to identify as this error and you need to write the answer but, right? And when it comes to the next one, Kalam asked his father that he wanted to leave Rameshwaram for high studies. We don't have any such kind of word, that is we have got the word I, but we are not supposed to use before the noun, we have to use the adjective. So here we need to use I here. So you should be very cautious, especially when doing such kind of errors. And next, here are some two or more examples which I have taken from the textbook, right? His wife watches us from behind the kitchen door, right? From behind the kitchen door. His wife, this is a tense based error. Actually, it has been completed. So we have to use his wife watched us. So we have to take the past form. Next, last. Iyer was not perturbed. Perturbed means disturbed. Nor he did not get angry on his wife. This is a phrasal verb. Always angry is followed with, right? I am angry with you, not on you. So we have to use angry is always followed by with. So these are the different rules you need to be followed in order to identify the errors. Right, children? Thank you.